Hey, South, we got an awesome show for you today. First up, we got some election results. Then, we got some stuff about a masked singer with I. Then, we have some former South athletes with Clayton. Then, we got some South teachers as athletes with Callie. Next, we got some IG math projects with Claudia. Then, we have a segment on advanced file sharing with Chandrea. And then, to end the show, we have some bloopers.
Welcome to the Raven Report. Today's November 6th and I'm Iman, and we're going to kick it off with the election results.
This past week's election is crazier than anyone can remember. Things are still up in the air for presidency, but other decisions have been made.
South decided to have a mock election, and here's who the Ravens thought should win for some major offices.
Joe Biden won South's mock election with 89.4% of the vote. Donald Trump got 10.6% of the vote. John Hickenlooper won the Senate seat of the mock election with 87% of the vote, while Cory Gardner got 13% of the vote. South alumni Diana DeGette won Colorado's first congressional district of the mock election with 88.5% of the vote. Shane Boylan got 11.5% of the vote.
So, how did these results play out in the actual election?
Democrat Diana DeGette won the Congress vote with 75.1%, and Shane Boylan had 22.6% of the vote.
John Hickenlooper won with 53.9% of the votes, while Cory Gardner received 44%.
But the presidential race is still up in the air. Biden needs Nevada's 6 electoral votes to reach 270, and Trump has a 0.3% lead over Georgia. Unfortunately, until we know the outcome of Nevada, we will still be patiently waiting to find out who our next president will be.
Make sure to stay tuned in to the Raven Report for another election update next week. And now, back to Iman at the desk.
Thank you, Chandrea, for that excellent report on the elections. Now, let's find out who won the pumpkin carving contest.
Amazing job to everyone who participated in the contest. Even though there were many awesome carvings, the winners are Daniel Gordon, Lily Pizzo, and Maggie Pan. Great job, ladies.
Congratulations to everyone who participated in the pumpkin carving contest. And now is our newest segment of the show, South's Masked Singer.
Hi guys, welcome to a new segment called The Masked Singer. So the rule for this segment is that we will have one special masked singer to perform, and you guys will have to guess who this special person is.
Alright, now let's go and see our special guest introduction.
Why you chose to sing?
I went to the Denver School of the Arts. I have training as a vocal music major, and I just thought I'd try out my luck, you know?
So I also heard that Dr. Rinaldi heard you sing in karaoke. Is that correct?
Oh yeah, karaoke's my thing. You know, I murder karaoke, so I thought I would get on here and show you how it's done.
Nice. And what song did you select? And why did you choose it?
So this song is called Heartless by Kanye West, and it's a song of heartbreak. I think I've had my fair share, and I think this is just a soulful way to express pain. I think learning positive ways to express hurtful situations can bring us into a better situation in life.
Well, thanks for participating, and let's go see your video.
Let's do this.
Oh, make sure to pay attention to this special singer in order to guess who it is.
In the night I hear a talk, the coldest story ever told. Somewhere far along this road he lost his soul to a woman so heartless. How could you be so heartless? Oh, how could you be so heartless? How could you be so cold as the winter wind when it breeze, yo? Just remember that you're talking to me, though. You need to watch the way you're talking to me, yo. I mean, after all the things that we've been through, I mean, after all the things that we got into. Hey, yo, I know some things that you ain't told me. Hey, yo, I did some things, but that's the old me. And now you're gonna get me back and you're gonna show me. So you walk around like you don't know me. You got new friends, well, I got homies. But in the end, it's still so lonely. In the night, I hear a talk, the coldest story ever told. Somewhere far along this road, I lost my soul to a woman so heartless. How could you be so heartless? Oh, how could you be so heartless?
Thank you. Well, do you all enjoy that video? Let's go see the candidates for our first Masked Singer.
So, who was the South staff that was singing? Was it Mr. Anders, Mr. Albin, Mr. Brooks, Mr. Buck, Mr. Fletcher, Mr. Cole, Mr. Craig, Mr. Connolly, Mr. Kelsey, Mr. McDonald, Mr. Childers, or Mr. Reynolds? Pick your staff Masked Singer and register who you guess it was at either our South Instagram or the Schoology poll.
If you want to know who our special singer is, tune in for next week. Thank you for watching.
Which staff member sang that awesome version of Heartless by Kanye West? Make sure to submit your guesses into Schoology and Instagram. And now on to tonight's opening of the fall play. South High Student Theater is proud to present our virtual fall play. The show must go on, and our amazingly talented students have worked hard putting together this wonderful production. Please check out their amazing performances. Almost Maine is a beautiful play that shows a wide variety of couples grappling with the complicated feelings of love all under the northern lights in Maine's winter sky. Please join us to watch the live stream tonight at 7 p.m. or Saturday, November 7th at 7 p.m. both on Zoom live streams using links which can be found on the South website and Schoology. The play is free. We are not selling tickets to watch it, but if you're feeling so inclined to donate to South High Student Theater, we would certainly welcome and appreciate your support. The link to donate can also be found in the Schoology announcement or South's website. So make sure you tune in tonight or tomorrow night at 7 to watch Almost Maine. And now on to Sports with Jackson.
Thank you, Iman, and welcome to sports. My name's Jackson, and first up, as many of you know, South has had quite a history with student-athletes playing at the next level. Here's an example of one of them.
Now let's see how former South student Esaias Gandy is doing at the University of Wyoming's football team.
I'm Esaias Gandy. I graduated in 2017, and I go to the University of Wyoming.
In high school, Esaias earned first-team All-State class in 4A from Chassa, Colorado Preps, and Max Preps. He was ranked number 5 in Colorado in tackles, totaling 155 tackles his senior year. He added 157 rushing yards and 2 rushing touchdowns, 243 receiving yards and 3 touchdown receptions, and accumulated an even 400 all-purpose yards his senior year. Esaias and the Denver South team posted an 11-1 overall record and a 5-0 conference record, winning the Mountain League title.
The Lindsays and like South in general just like prepared me like to come to college for sure, because I don't know if I was at any other school if I'd be here right now. I'm just grateful just to be here, you feel me, to play, to represent Colorado, and just Denver South. And
now playing for the University of Wyoming, Esaias appeared in 12 games and earned a start against Boise State. He finished the season with 24 total tackles and recovered 2 fumbles, tying for the team lead. He recorded a career-high 6 tackles against Idaho and added 4 tackles in the season opener against Missouri.
Great leaders like in front of me, like Dewey and Marcus, they've just been great leaders and taught me like everything I'm known now. And I just took what they I saw what they did and I just did it myself. Really.
Good luck, Asias, and congratulations on all your accomplishments. Make sure to go support the Wyoming Cowboys on the 19th against Utah State.
Thank you, Clayton, for such an amazing segment on Asias Gandy. If you want to catch him in the action, he'll be playing Air Force next Saturday. And now, on to teachers trying to relive their glory athletic days. Guess you can guess how that turned out.
Hey, South. It's Callie here with a segment highlighting some teachers who were former athletes. This week's teacher is...
Mr. Speicher, but I also go by Coach Blade sometimes. I teach math in the math department, so I teach Math 1, Math 2, and I also teach our newcomers.
In high school, Mr. Speicher played football, baseball, and was on the wrestling team.
And I was a captain for my football team. We weren't very good, but I led the team in touchdowns, so that was pretty cool. But my sophomore year, our wrestling team had a lot of seniors, and I really wanted to help them do really well and help the team do really well. So I actually quit football for a year to focus on wrestling.
Mr. Speicher even dressed up as his school's mascot, Wolfie, for a year.
And then like my main sport was wrestling. I was fifth in state my senior year, and then that's what I ended up going to college for. College was a lot tougher than high school, and I didn't have as much success, but it was, I think, a really good experience in being part of a college team. And I had some big matches where like I won the duel for my team, but like, I think my favorite experience ever was actually, it was a loss, but I had a really close match with the number 3 guy in the country who beat me 5-3, but I made him work for it. So that was like, you know, a really cool moment for me.
In spring of 2019, Mr. Speicher participated in Haymakers for Hope, a charity boxing tournament centered around cancer-related charities.
So I got trained to box at Topiary Gym for 4 months. And while I was doing that, I was fundraising. My particular charity was Dana-Farber Cancer Institute in Boston. That's where my mom had cancer, and unfortunately she passed, but that's where she got taken care of. But all the fighters can pick their own cancer charity. So I raised $12,000 individually. As an organization, all the Denver fighters raised close to $300,000, and it all culminated in one big event at the Fillmore Auditorium where we got to fight under the lights, and it was the coolest athletic experience of my life. I felt like a professional. So I fought under the name Blade the Babe, and had a really good showing of support from people, and it was a really fun night.
Although Mr. Speicher played many different sports, the one common thread that linked them all was...
It was great when my teams won, but the thing I cherished the most was just being part of those teams and the memories I had meeting my friends and just spending time with my teammates.
Thanks, Mr. Speicher, for telling us about your awesome high school and college athletic career. See you next time, Ravens.
Thank you, Mr. Speicher, for showing us how much of a stud you were. Next time when you're going into a boxing match, maybe try, you know, give him the good old left hook, win, you know. Anyways, that'll be it for me today. Back to Iman on the desk. See you guys.
Thanks, Jackson, for that wonderful sports recap. Have you guys checked out these amazing math projects?
Hey, South. Some of our math classes did projects on some underrepresented mathematicians. Let's go check out some of the best ones.
name is Natalie. I'm a sophomore, and this was for math class.
I'm Alana Kingsborn, and this is for my math class.
Why did you choose this person for your project?
It was Katherine Johnson, just because I think that she's like such a role model. She was such a powerful woman, and she just kind of broke all the gender norms at that time, and she produced great work from it. So I think it's really inspirational to learn more about her.
I chose Sophie Dumas because she is French, and I love learning about French culture, and I think it's like very interesting.
I think that this was a sign so that we could, you know, really see math contextualize, you know, in real life, because I think a lot of times we ask ourselves, why are we learning what we're learning? But then we learn about people who actually used math to do good things that changed our world. And I think it's good to put that, you know, into perspective and learn about people who did a lot of good.
We got assigned us to learn how people in the past used math in everyday life and outside of like work and school.
What did you learn from this?
I just learned about all of her achievements, and I think I respected her when I first started the project, but I just left respecting her even more. Without her equations and her dedication and her, you know, wanting to break those gender norms, I don't think that we would be where we are today. So I just learned like her importance and the impact she had.
I learned that Sophie pretended to be a man to learn about math from this professor, because at the time they didn't allow women to learn math. She found the Sophie Germain theory, which is named after her.
Great job to everyone who worked on these projects. Now we're gonna head back to the desk with Iman.
Are you doing anything next Wednesday during lunch? Join BSA for their guest speaker series.
On Wednesday the 11th, BSA will be welcoming Elijah Huff as part of their Black Business Owner guest speaker series. The Google Meet code is SouthBSA, so make sure to join.
Just a reminder that the food bank is open from 3 to 5:30 p.m. at South in the East parking lot on Thursdays. Well, that's all from me. Hope you enjoyed. Now it's time for the bloopers.
I off-brand Gucci slides, but I also hit dingers.
Thanks, Claudia. This is Sports. I'm Hadley, and today we're going to be talking about the softball team.
Thanks, guys, for that piece on clubs. If any of that sounds interesting to you, make sure to reach out and join some new clubs. And now, let's hope it.
Shoot my thumbs out.
Ready? 3, 2.
So make sure to share all your...
Oh my gosh. When you're ready,
make sure to...
I count for you.
Hello, Denver South families. Welcome to our back to school night. I'm Bethany, and I'm gonna help show you how to access your child's Schoology to see teacher introduction videos.
Make sure you check out the old school archives. Now on to
my home video archives.
Dang it!
I'm back to South High School and asking more questions, and we will answer them. That's messed up. You gotta cut that out.
The reason why I joined this club, or I'm in this club, is because... Hold on.
Thanks for a wonderful sports update, Georgia. And now, we have some internship opportunities available. You're eligible if you have...
Start!
Thanks, Bethany.
Three, two.
After this, we only have
have two left.
Okay.
Like I said, it's a short sports. All right, you're recording. Frame yourself up in your shot. 3, 2.
Thanks, Conch.
3, 2.
Welcome, South to New Stack. Oh my God.
3, 2.
Welcome, South's new staff. We're excited to have you. Now, oh my God, I literally cannot speak right now.
No! No, I don't think that is good. Oscar is interfering.
Stop it.
Because I took you, but when you say 3, 2, 1, I did.
All right, here.
But I don't know. Now it's on a square in the bottom. It's okay?
That means it's recording right now.
Okay.
So press it again.
And we're back from sports. Thank you, Iman, for that awesome segment on sports today. Now it's time for your favorite segment and mine, Teacher Throwback Thursday.
But it's Friday.
Oh, shoot. Oh, my gosh. It was so good.